All right, everybody. So in this video, I'm going to show you kind of what I go through to set up my HF station when I'm doing summits on the air. This peak's nice and big, lots of area. But the first thing I want to consider is, where do I want to sit and what terrain do I have near me that's going to work? Now, knowing in this particular situation, I've got a nice wide open area. But the thing I'm going to choose to do is I'm going to choose to sit up against the back of this trash dumpster area. And then we have some shade for at least a little while the sun's rolling over me. And then I'll probably dip around the corner over there and get more shade. So that's kind of where I'm planning on sitting, is basically right here on this corner. And that way I can stay in the shade. Obviously get the hat on, I get a lot of sun exposure. So that's the first consideration, is where do I want to sit? So the second consideration is, what room and what orientation do I want to use with my antenna? So I'm going to try to run this thing a little bit northeast, where the broadside, if this was the ends of the dipole, the broadsides are kind of a northeast southwest orientation, because I'm going to try to kind of push it. Like if I'm in Southern California, ideally what I want to do is I want to get up toward New York. I'm still making contacts into Massachusetts in that area with the legs running just north south, almost directly north south. But this time I'm going to kick it just a little bit and see if I can cover some more terrain. So that's the first consideration I have. All right, so here is the gear just for my antenna for my HF station. All these items can be found on my website. This is the 5.4 meter bamboo pole, 17 feet roughly, 5.4 meters around there, but small, that actually fits inside of my backpack. I think it's 18 inches high is what I was told. So it fits inside of my backpack, or is easy to pack compared to the other wonder pole you saw in my gear video. These are the new cordage that I got from one of the subscribers, and I forgot his handle already, I apologize, but I will link his channel below. And then I took these little chain links off of here, and these are what I'm using to guy off the telescoping pole. And then what I did here is I just put these zip tie around here, and then if you could see the hole right there, these are the kind of zip ties that you can actually put a screw through. And I will link those as well, but I just got these at like Home Depot, but they're readily available anywhere. So I have three of them on there, three of these little hooks, and triangulate out. These two, and notice the colors too. This has a reflective non-sticky coat to it and is reflective at night. And then these ones are what I'm gonna put on the ends of this particular type of zip tie, which is the other end of these. And then that way I could just clip those little links, same little links in there. This is 550 cord. I'll probably buy more of this stuff, but it is kind of expensive. 30 feet was about 15 bucks, 33 feet, 30 meters, about 15 bucks. Then these little things right here are gonna go right into this back of the zip tie here, and that's how I adjust my legs out either way. And then of course, the speaker wire antenna. This one is cut dead nuts for 14.250, 20 meters. And that's able to tune up on 40 through 10. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get my tent stakes out. I got some aluminum ones, super lightweight, and a couple other ones. I gotta buy some more aluminum ones. And I'm gonna just go ahead and position up the guy lines and get the pole ready to go in the orientation that I want. So that's what I'm gonna do now. All right, so the next thing I wanna do is I want to kind of just lay things out and figure out kind of roughly how far away from my seating arrangement that I wanna be. With that, you know, if you decide to make one of these speaker wire antennas, highly effective, super lightweight, I will tell you that this part of it, there's two parts. So there's the knot. You can see that all this in the video, then each one of these legs are spread out. And then in the knot, I have a zip tie and I have a swivel, and I carry one of those binding clips too that I'll put on there. But I wanna make sure that I've got enough room or length of the transmission line portion to get to where I'm seating, accounting for the elevation as well. So just gonna unravel this briefly. It don't take a second here. And then, it looks like I got more than enough. So an important step is kind of priming the pole a little bit. Better get a couple of these little legs out, because once you pull them up tight, that way it's like this. Because if you go ahead and fasten it down and guy it down without doing that, then you're taking it and you're kind of messing up the guys. So I kind of always pull this out just a little bit, then I just lay it down. Take the cap, I put it in my pocket, and then I'm gonna grab my guy lines. So, with the guy lines,
First I'll do is guy this thing out, and I'll just kind of throw these takes out. And I like to kind of do it where the transmission line tends to pull the antenna that way a little bit. So I want one of the guy lines almost directly opposite of me out that way. And then I do one kind of at an angle to where I triangulate it a little bit to where the other two legs are kind of open to me, kind of like how you do a tripod. And that way my transmission line will kind of keep everything just in position. So put one out here, tail, go. Move. Doesn't need to be very far out. And this is where, you know, I just use a rock. Plenty of rocks in Southern California. Use a rock. Tap it in a little. Open up one of the guy lines. And then tie it up. So I'll speed up the video and then you can see kind of how I tie all these things off. An important part of this is make sure you angle the stakes outward. So the back stake should be angled like this, like that, so that when the guy lines pull on it, it's got a little bit of tension. I do two loops around, sometimes three, and then I just tie a slip knot through there, and that's more than enough. The third one is the one that I use to adjust the actual tension, and I just basically pull it into place. And that way, you know, it's easier to set up that way when you're by yourself. So just kind of pull this to where it was tight on both legs. Pop that in there, like that. And sometimes if I got soft ground, I'll just kind of mash it in there, maybe put a couple rocks around. I don't have that here. So, and you don't want to pull too tight. You pull too tight, it just doesn't make sense. And that's all it takes for that. It doesn't take a lot. You can see that's good enough. So now that that's up, one more item. And I just take the swivel and I just slide it on top of this, like so. Now it goes down kind of far. I could put a smaller swivel, and I probably will, and that'll probably get me up here. But the SOTA flag. So once we have that up, or on there I should say, I should bring it up just a couple lengths, about like that. Just high enough right now. SOTA flags, I'll put the link in the description, but you can get these on the SOTA website. And if you haven't been to the SOTA website, you should go to the SOTA website. I mean, you're playing SOTA. Gear snakes on my website, you can find them there. And it's not too windy here. If it's too windy, I might forget the flag sometimes because it'll pull on this pole, or I'll put the flag somewhere else, but it all depends. So when it's about this high, that's when I start looking at my compass so that I can orient where I want. So from where I'm at, the compass, well, there we go. Actually, running it this way right here is going to put me kind of where I want, broadside legs. It's going to go northwest. So that's northwest over there. That's kind of the general direction we're going to go. Get my other tent stakes. Now the idea is to get these legs off of the ground a little ways. The further they're off the ground, the more horizontal they are. Again, I think the more directivity, as in exactly a dipole. But bringing them down to about a 45 gives us the inverted V, and it seems to be pretty omni, but I still like to try to find directivity if I can. I will admit, this is, or can be, the hardest part, is making sure that these lines don't get tangled up when you're doing this, because you're moving everything around. So that's why I'm showing you this video, so you know how to do this, make it easy for yourself. So I've got it all spread out just like that, and I'll lay them out into position first, and I think I said it's going to go about right here. First I try to look for some kind of bush, which in this case I have enough to make it there, but my concern is that this leg will be up higher than that leg, and that'll just be funky because there's nothing on that side over there. So right about here. Again, you don't want these too tight to begin with because you still got to bring the pole up. So if it's too tight, it ain't gonna work that good. But the pole will bend, and that's the best part of this whole setup. So. Okay, so some important facts here, some important parts to remember. So see how this speaker wire is? Each leg going out, which is good. Not tangled up, not twisted. You don't want this thing all twisted up like that. That ain't gonna do you very good, I don't think. You can see how the swivel's on there. Put a smaller swivel, less of a taper, which I need to do when I get home, and it'll obviously be up higher. And give you a little bit more elevation. The transmission line, again, these are the radiating elements, and right here, the transmission line, as I bring it down, I put it underneath this right here, just to kind of keep it a little bit more at a 90 degree angle. You're getting quite a ride here. So, see how I'm pulling on this? That transmission line's staying there. I'm kind of hung up right here. All the way back to where I'm at. So hopefully you can see this in the shade, the sun right there. So there's your transmission line. It's around here. That's another benefit of these. It kind of holds it in place right there. It's not dependent necessarily on these. And these you can slide around the zip ties. So if they're just off a little bit, you can fix those and spin it around. So the flag's on. These are metal. So just know that. If it starts giving you any issues, which it hasn't given me any. Radiating elements out with plenty of room. You can see where it's staked off over there. On both sides, I'm a little looser on this side, but I'll make those adjustments here in just a minute. So, put this down. All right, so the first thing, before we make any adjustments on the legs, is to raise the pole up all the way. That's why it's good to have a lot of slack in these lines. I went out pretty far because I like to get those legs up off the ground as much as I can. So again, slip knot, do it, and when we go about halfway up, I mean, it could go a little more, probably go about that far. And then what I do, this thing, this rope's in the way here a little bit, there's a notch. I wrap it around, almost like a dock line. I just kind of go over and like that. Let me show you that. So one of the things I do, just like when you're wrapping a boat off. So I just wrapped it around a few times so you can kind of adjust it. You can see that little notch right there. It's a little notch in the tent stake. So I go around twice, move it off of that so it doesn't interfere. And then just a loop
You know, put like two fingers in there and around like that. And that's all you need. It's not like wazoo. It's pretty simple. So we've got it up here. Now see how this is off the ground a good distance. That's good. We got a little bit of a bend, which gives me the ability to bring this leg up a little bit so that we can get some more distance off the ground on here. And same thing. So I'm gonna adjust this leg. All I gotta do is just loosen it up a little bit and then around. One time. All you gotta do is go around that thing one time. So now what I like to do is I like to look at it. Look at it, make sure it's almost like a 45, which it is pretty close. I could probably come up a little bit more on this side. Get out of the sun view. So you see how that pole's tilted to the left? So I'm gonna loosen up this arm a little bit, just so that pole is straight up and down. And then we'll be set. And there we go. That's all it's got to do. Now, if it's really windy out, you know, might want to cinch it down a little bit more or dig these in. I notice a little bit of slack in this, tight, so I can tighten this up, or I just move this around a little bit, kind of get it centered again. You can see this transmission line, see it sliding out. So this upside, straight up and down, like that. Get it off of the SOTA flag. And that's it. So that's how you set up the speaker wire antenna. Three guy points. You want more, knock yourself out, but I don't think it's too necessary. Sometimes I just shove that right into a pile of rocks. Doesn't have to be completely vertical. It can be canted to a side. Who cares? Does not have to be perfect. And then each one of the legs, about as much as a 45 as you can get. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tighten down the one side. Last thing I'll add, this is a bonus tip. So bonus tip time. Move that out of the way. So bonus tip. I use this roll-up J-pole. On the roll-up J-pole is a zip tie on one end. I can put that up there in that paper clip. I can put it on the tire wires. I can put it anywhere up there I want. I got enough of a length that I actually have my HT hanging down sometimes. So that's kind of what I put in place. But usually after I'm done making my contacts, maybe I'll set this up, or if I need help spotting, I'll set it up, because it does make a difference on VHF. I think it's awesome. So I usually don't put that up until I need to or I want to, simply because that's a whole bunch more metal I'm introducing into the equation. So I try not to, even though the KX2 tunes everything out perfectly. So anyways, hope that helps you out right there. Hey, if you got some value out of that, you know, sound like a YouTuber now, I'd really appreciate it if you'd hit like, but more importantly, if you'd subscribe and make some comments on there, how you set it up and what you would do differently, or if you've got some other ideas that I hadn't considered or put on here. It's kind of our channel, not my channel. And if there's somebody out there that's got a better way to do it, I'd like to know. So anyways, hopefully that helps you out.